My name is G, and in this recitation video, we're going to be covering an electric field problem due to point charges. Behind the camera, as always, is Dave.
Hey guys.
And here's the problem. In this problem, we're tasked with finding the Y component of the electric field due to the described charge configuration. So first, like every physics problem, we need to draw a picture. So we're told that, given our X and Y axes here, the first charge, Q1, which is negative 2 little q, is a distance A above the origin on the Y axis. Now Q2 is on the origin directly and has a charge of positive 5q. And lastly, Q3, which has a charge of negative q over 2, is a distance 3a over 2 from the origin. Now, with these three charges in mind, we need to find the electric field at this point I'll call P, the fourth corner of that rectangle. Now that we know what this configuration looks like, we need to use our knowledge of electric fields to find out what the overall electric field will be. And each one of these charges has its own contribution. So starting with Q1, which has a negative charge, we know that all negative charges have electric field lines that point directly toward the charge. So the electric field due to Q1, what I'll call E1, is pointed horizontally to the left. Now Q2 is a positive charge, and those electric field lines point away. So we know that E2 is like so. And lastly, using that same knowledge, we know that Q3 is negative. This implies that the electric field for Q3, E3, is going to be vertically downward. So the overall Y component of the electric field is going to be the sum of each Y component of each of these individual electric fields. That is EY total is going to be the Y component of E1 plus the Y component of E2 and the Y component of E3. Now, taking these piece by piece, let's consider E1 first. And we can see that E1 is horizontal to the left, meaning it only has an X component. So right away, we know that E1 in the Y direction is 0, and our life just got a little easier. Next, we look at E2, which is without a doubt the hardest. And we see that E2 has X and Y component. Here's its Y component, and here's its X component. Now, in order to get E2 in the Y direction, we have to introduce this angle theta, which happens to be the same theta that's here. That'll come in handy later on. Now, using geometry, we know that E2 in the Y direction has to be equal to the magnitude of E2 times sine of that angle theta. And lastly, E3 in the Y direction is gotten by just seeing that all of E3 is pointing in that negative Y direction. So there's no X component. That means that E3 in the Y direction is negative the magnitude of E3. Now, this brings us to the total Y component of the electric field is just 0 plus E2 sine theta minus magnitude of E3. Now, recall that the electric field due to a point charge is equal to K Q over R squared, where K is Coulomb's constant and R is the distance between the charge Q and the point in space we're considering. So we see that the Y component then becomes a little more complicated. We have K E2 is given by Q2 over what I'll call R2 squared, sine theta, minus K times Q3 over R3 squared. Now we haven't labeled what R2 and R3 are yet, and we're not sure what sine theta is in terms of the quantities given, so let's refer back to our diagram. R2 is the distance between the charge Q2 and the point P space. That would be this quantity right here. And R3 is the distance between Q3 and the point in space we're considering at point P. That would be here. So in terms of quantities given, we see that R3 is equal to A. That one's the most straightforward. Now R2 is given by Pythagorean theorem. That is that R2 is going to be the square root of the lengths of the sides squared. So 3a over 2 all squared plus the other side, R3, which we know is a squared. And this evaluates to the square root of 13 over 2 times a. And we know a at this point. Lastly, what we don't know is sine of theta. And that's given also by this triangle. And we can see that sine, being the opposite over the hypotenuse, is just R3 divided by R2. Or in terms of A, we have the square root of 13, just A over the square root of 13, A over 2. These cancel, and we get 2 over the square root of 13. Now, plugging all of this back in, we reach our grand finale. Ey is going to be K times Q2, which is just 5Q, all over R2 squared, which is just going to be 13A squared over 2, over 4. And then times sine of theta, which we found was just 2 over square root of 13. Then minus the magnitude of E3, which is K times Q3, which is negative Q over 2, all over R3 squared, which is just A squared. Now, with A being 1 meter, and Q being 1 nanocoulomb, and K being Coulomb's constant, which is given, this should evaluate to 3.18 newtons per coulomb. Now, for a bonus, I encourage you to find the X component of the electric field, as well as the overall electric field and direction. The answers will be given in the description below. Thanks again for watching. Thanks, Dave, and good luck.